Hello, Karina. Essa here from Social Media Worldwide, and in this video I want to share with you the 6 biggest mistakes to avoid on Pinterest. With 200 million monthly active Pinterest users, there's no doubt it's a powerful social network for marketing, especially if your main target audience is women, since 80% of Pinterest users are women. And to make sure you make the most out of your Pinterest marketing efforts, here are 6 common mistakes to avoid. Mistake number 1, not optimizing your account. In other words, not adding a properly sized profile picture. Profile pictures should be 165 times 165 pixels to fit perfectly. When it comes to choosing your profile picture, you have 2 choices. Either a headshot of you if you are the face of your brand, like Tony Robbins, for example. If that's the case, make sure your profile is not cropped, is not a selfie, is not pixelated, or make sure it doesn't have a messy or busy background, as it can make you come across as unprofessional. Instead, put a close-up picture of you, head and shoulders ideally, facing the camera and smiling, like this one, for example. The second option is to put a logo as a profile picture if you are not the face of your brand, like Starbucks or Nike. In terms of dimensions, the same applies, 165 times 165 pixels. Then make sure you add a bio that underlines who you are, what you do, how you help people, and who you help. For example, your bio could be paleo diet specialist, helping overweight men aged 40 and over lose weight through online information products and food supplements. Or anti-aging advocate, helping men and women over 40 improve the quality of their skin and regain their confidence thanks to scientifically proven anti-aging cosmetic products. The next step to optimize your Pinterest account is adding your website URL or any URL you want your Pinterest audience to visit, such as your YouTube channel or your other social network accounts. Then make sure your username is user-friendly. It should be easy to spell and easy to remember to make it easier for people to remember and find you on Pinterest. Plus, your username should not exceed 15 characters. Your username could be your first and last name if you are the face of the brand, as long as it's not already taken. Or it could be a keyword-rich username, such as pinterest.com/organic-skincare. Mistake number 2, not pinning on a regular basis. If you've decided to market on Pinterest, you'll have to commit to publishing pins regularly, once a day or at least a few times a week. If this sounds tricky, then we recommend using tailwindapp.com. This tool allows you to schedule pins in advance. Simply click on publish, then click on schedule pins and click on upload images. Plus, this tool already shows you when are the best times to schedule your pins for, to increase the chances of your pins being seen by your followers. Mistake number 3, not creating engaging pins. Pins that are either irrelevant to your audience or are not informational. Ideally, your pins should be 735 pixels wide and 1102 pixels long. Plus, they should be multi-dimensional. In other words, you shouldn't always be publishing the same types of pins. Instead, try and vary the type of content you share. Between quotes, infographics, humor, cartoons, videos, how-to demos, pictures of people, statements, etc. To come up with ideas for engaging pins, type in the search box keywords relevant to your business and look at the most popular pins and try to model them. The more engagement they have received, the more popular they are. The 4th mistake to avoid is not optimizing your Pinterest boards. Pinterest boards are the equivalent of folders to categorize your pins. To create boards, simply go to your profile and then click on Create Boards. When optimizing your boards, it's important they have a keyword-rich title. For example, avoid naming your board Things I Like. Instead, be more specific. For example, your board title could be Easy Vegan Dinner Recipes. To get ideas for attention-grabbing board titles, perform a search on Pinterest. Simply type in a keyword relevant to your business in the search bar, then click on Boards. There you'll see all the board titles which include your keyword. Then make sure you add a keyword-rich description for your board, such as discover over 100 vegan dinner recipes that require no more than 20 minutes to prepare and serve up to 4 people for under $10. Remember to also create a board cover. Your board cover should be an image with the title of your board so it stands out from other boards. Then reshuffle your boards by dragging and dropping them to make sure your most popular pins appear at the top of your profile. The 5th mistake to avoid on Pinterest is not tracking. When you have a business Pinterest account, you can access analytics to discover information about your audience and your pins so you can do more of what works and less of what doesn't. You can access more detailed analytics within Pinterest when you confirm your website. Simply click on Confirm Website and follow the prompts. You can track even further by using tools such as clickmeter.com, which tracks how many clicks your links are getting. To track how many email subscribers you're getting, access the analytics in your autoresponder system. For example, with Infusionsoft, an email autoresponder system, you can easily see how many new subscribers each of your campaigns has gotten you. Mistake number six, not keyword optimizing. You see, on Pinterest, each pin should have a keyword-rich title and a keyword-rich description. Avoid naming pins with broad, generic keywords such as gift ideas. Instead, be more specific. For example, you can name your pin gift ideas for men over 40. To come up with keyword-rich pin names, type your keyword in the search bar and see what keywords Pinterest suggests. Or check other pins for title ideas. The more specific your keyword is, the more likely your pin will show up at the top of the search results. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, I've got an even better bonus for you. If you want to know how to leverage the power of Pinterest even further, I've got my Pinterest account optimization video tutorial. I'm going to play a preview in just a second. Click the tab on this video and it's going to take you to where you've got instant access to that full video. Plus, you're going to get another 3 videos from our best-selling Pinterest Pro Home Study course, and it's not going to cost you anything. In these additional 3 bonus videos, I'll reveal how to leverage the power of Pinterest group boards for more traffic, how to monetize your Pinterest account even if you're a complete beginner, and how to scale your Pinterest marketing efforts thanks to the power of Pinterest ads. If you've got any questions, put them in the comments below. Click on the thumbs up, it really helps us out. And also remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel, that way you'll see our newest videos. See you soon.
Hello and welcome to this video where I'll share with you how to create and optimize your Pinterest account. So to create a Pinterest business account, go to business.pinterest.com and click on join as business. But if you already have a Pinterest account that is not a business account, then still go to business.pinterest.com and it will ask you to convert your current account into a business account. Instead of join as a business, it will say convert. So click on convert and follow the prompts. So here, let's pretend we don't have an account. So let's get started. I'll click on join as a business and then it will ask you for your email address. So put an email address which you have the login details to, you have access to, because sometimes if you can't log into your Pinterest account, it's good to have access to the email account associated to the Pinterest account just in case something happens with the logins to your Pinterest account. It can be really tricky sometimes if you no longer have access to the email address associated to your Pinterest account. It can be really tricky to log in again. So I'm just going to put an email address I have created. Then choose a password. Make sure that you save your password somewhere that you remember. So I'll just create a password here. Now the business name, you have 2 choices. It can be your personal name.